This is CNN, the world's news network.
The reported numbers of Tunisians who are said to be fighting in Syria, who are reported to have joined terrorist organizations such as ISIS as well as the al-Nusra Front, flow of jihadists from neighboring Libya ever since an ISIS presence.
Hundreds of tourists from cruise ships had disembarked from buses at the museum when the gunmen, dressed in military uniforms, jumped from a vehicle and began firing indiscriminately.
Economically, this will affect Tunisia because tourism is really important to the country. Also, on top of that, Tunisians are concerned about whether this is just a one-off attack or the beginning of a campaign of attacks.
I'm Rena Ninen with the top stories on this Thursday, March 19th. The fallout from a shooting rampage overseas is being felt here in the U.S. Security beefed up at museums in New York and other cities following a deadly attack on tourists at a popular museum in Tunisia.
Terrorist attack. Any idea if this is homegrown terrorism? Indeed, the fears had been growing, had they not, in Tunisia, that some of the militants could spill across, some of the unrest from Libya could spill across its border.
They have a lot of Tunisians in them, but may include Algerians or Malians, it's been reported, or other people from other parts of Africa. Whichever group is responsible, it's probably similar jihadist ideology seeking to damage Tunisia's tourist trade, which of course is so important for its economy.
Hundreds of tourists from cruise ships had disembarked from buses at the museum when the
gunmen,
Several tourists were then reportedly taken hostage,
but the number of captives was unclear. Economically,
Tunisian security forces later made their way into the museum and killed the two gunmen, ending a three-hour siege.
Also, on top of that, Tunisians are concerned about when this is just a one-off attack,
Japanese, Italian, Colombian, Spanish, Australian, Polish, and French nationals.
I think that there's a huge difference between what the media represents for North Africa and Tunisia and what is here on the ground. The people here thus far have been absolutely brilliant, intelligent, hardworking, strong, multilingual. The landscapes, like I said, is absolutely beautiful. The culture is so rich and deep. Like, you can find anything from Roman antiquities to Jewish cemeteries to Muslim kasbahs and forts that really show rich and deep history that Tunisia has to offer.
They were putting over and over those videos about the attacks, and I decided actually to avoid watching that because it creates an image of Tunisia which is not what is real actually.
The situation I got on the ground is not like the way it was blown on the media houses around the world about the issues of the museum. And it is friendly, and I thank the people who stood firm to ensure that this place is good for visitors and good for citizens.
Listening to the news and listening to the Western perspective on these events that happened last week, you do get a feeling of uncertainty. However, we need to see beyond that. We need to see and experience the life in Tunisia, the life in other places around the world that are going through situations. We need to stand together, and we need to see beyond what we hear in the news and push through and be here in solidarity.
In between planning to come to Tunisia, there was this issue of gunmen attacking people in the museum, and you know, all the world, the CNN, all the likes just started talking about this, that, and you know, I just say, oh no, organizers should not stop my program. I want to go to Tunisia. I want to see that country.
It's my first time in Tunisia, and I've been here for 1 week now. I arrived on 1 week ago, and on the day before the attacks happened, I felt very fortunate to have the opportunity of meeting all the amazing Tunisian people that I was meeting on that day, and to talk to them, and they were so kind with us all the time and very friendly, and I was not really feeling anything related to any danger, or I was not feeling fear or anything being here even on that day.
Before I came in, it was this conception of fight, war, terrorism, you know, it created a fear before I came, naturally, you know, but I told myself that I want to see what is happening, you know. And now that I came, the people are lovely people, warm people, good culture, very encouraging, very helpful. Even when I cannot communicate with them properly, you see somebody else walking along the street will come and say, okay, this is what he's trying to say.
So it's my first time in Tunisia. I didn't hesitate to come, even though the last events were really pressuring this event and threatening this event. That's why I think it was even more important to come. And it gives even more awareness, brings more awareness to the importance of democracy, freedom of speech, and not being afraid.
I never had a doubt about coming. Somehow I think I'm not so obsessed with security because I think life is dangerous anyway and totally uncertain. So I think we need to overcome this speech of fear and of words like terrorism and to really look for what to unite us and to trust that we, no matter how much we look for security, we should do what our heart tells us to do. And my heart told me that my place is here with colleagues and friends who are trying to make a difference. And I'm really inspired by the revolutions. I think Tunisia was on the front in that.
I came to Tunisia 3 weeks ago. Every time I got into a taxi in Sousse, and they were saying, like, haram, astaghfirullah, like this. And they were so sad, like the same as I was. And I think as we are all people, like we want the best for everyone. And for someone to do something like that is just like, it's not a normal occurrence in a place like this. And that was just really disheartening.
So when preparing the trip, I was really, really excited actually to go to Tunisia. So when I arrived, actually, I met with other friends from the training. We sat down in the terrace, just having a tea or a coffee. And we saw that actually people were just living normal lives and relaxed, and it did not feel like it was a place like under attack. Then I forgot about it. I remembered of it just because my mother was like texting me every day, asking me, is everything all right? I saw on the news that security is high, can you confirm? But besides that, actually it's more like the outside fear from the people around you than really an inside fear.
I really try to share with people that I was feeling very secure here and safe here, and that the country is amazing and the people are amazing, and what happened, there is nothing to do with any kind of nationality or religion or anything.
So when I first found out about the attack, I was sitting with some friends and colleagues in the Medina, in the historic part of Tunis, and we were very much saddened by the fact that people died during the shootings. At the same time, there were a lot of misconceptions by the foreign media about what happened and who was at fault. And I think one of the things that I've learned being here and living in Tunis is to really contextualize the situation, the politics of what's going on.
To tell everybody about the world that Africans are friendly people, we are not terrorists, we are not bad people, and all we just need to do is for them to get a story from our own perspective, not a foreign perspective, really.
I decided to come to say that we're not afraid of what's happening and we are stronger. On the first day, we went to buy a telephone chip, and the woman selling the telephone chip said it was really nice to see tourists coming to Tunisia, and I felt that she was really profoundly touched by the presence of people here, and this is a very moving moment for me.
We are in an amazing country with amazing food, amazing climate. It's really, really beautiful.
Of course, the food
is amazing. The everything you see around you. I was very happy to see the old city, talk with local people, and experience the culture. Everybody should get a chance to experience that.
I went to the cities surrounding Tunis, to Carthage and Sidi Bou Said, and I love those two cities. In Carthage, we visited many beautiful places, and we went to a cathedral where there were happening a street dance competition. This was a very nice experience as well.
The green tea, I like it, at the Medina. And also the Medina place is a nice place, but I like the tea and I like the couscous because I ate couscous in Libya before. And Tunisian couscous is better than Libyan couscous.
The food is great, olive oil is always present, and actually I like this little detail of the spicy, of the harissa, that what it brings to the tastes and the flavors of the Tunisian cuisine.
For the couscous, I've seen that before in Nigeria, in northern Nigeria. It is not called couscous, it's called babrisco. And what we do is that we instead of taking it with spoon, we mold it and put it inside a soup and just munch it that way. And it's white, we don't add anything to it really.
I've already been invited to people's homes and eaten couscous and gotten recipes for malkhia. Of course, I've eaten leblebi and had harita and everything.
And the Tunisian salad. The Tunisian salad is a unique salad.
Maklub and with cheese, actually. And it's the first dish I had overnight and was really amazing.
I love the brick with tuna and lemon. I also like the chakchuka and the tea. When I came the first time, I was in Bizerte and it was really nice. I also like some of the beaches that are less touristy, which were very nice, and the different little ports. So, but also being in the Medina with lots of things happening and the souk, and I like that too.
Tunisia for me has been a very warm and open and compassionate space. People have been very willing to take me into their homes, to visit small towns in places like Lekef and Gasserine, which are technically considered red zones, but have been absolutely beautiful. I have not had that kind of hospitality per se in small towns in the United States where I'm from. And so it's been wonderful that North Africans and Tunisians have always been willing to show me their country and their homes, especially in a moment of transition.
Try to come to Tunisia and see for themselves, because exposure is very important. When you are exposed, you can talk from informed perspective, you can interact with people, learn people's culture, because Tunisia is in Africa. So the Africans must know where their boundaries stop and they should be able to interact with people.
And the Tunisian people, they are always kind with us. And being a Brazilian, I could see also lots of similarities between our culture and the Tunisian culture.
I have good memories of the South also. So yeah, it's really being totally feeling at home.
Tunisia is an amazing country. It has the culture and the spirit of the Mediterranean.
Africans are very friendly people, and it never diminishes anywhere you go. And so, on that stand, I'm always impressed with Africans everywhere. You tell me they look like Arabs, they are different from you. No. We are one and very friendly people.
The people are very kind. The weather is becoming beautiful because of the spring season. Especially now with this time, it's a great vacation spot for those of you who are interested in coming. Right now, there are just so many new things and new programs starting. They have a balloon festival in Sousse, and now we're having the World Social Forum, which is just this open place for people to share about organizations and movements, and it's really exciting.
And like, as a response to violence, it's important to maintain this presence because it's the best answer to violence.
Vive la Tunisie! Vive la Tunisie!
I have total trust that we are doing the path in the right direction, and I hope we get more and more inspiration by the path that the young Tunisians are doing for a better future.
To trust everything that was said when there was a revolution, especially that it was young people that wanted a change and they still want it, and they are still fighting for that.
You know, it should be one of the places you would think that you would get to before you die if you have such list. Instead of going to Europe, this is a beautiful place to come to and have fun.
Please come and visit this very beautiful country to enjoy. I'm sure you'll be surprised. Yes.
I like the place. I will be leaving on Sunday, but I will come back.
So I encourage everyone to visit if they have a chance, because I've personally learned a lot just by being here.
Tunisia is very beautiful. It's beautiful beyond my imagination. I would always want to come back and back and back and back.
هو عبر التاريخ تونس ما نجم يقعد فيها حتى حد اكستريميسم حتى حد متطرف والشعب التونسي هذا يحب الفن يحب الموسيقى يحب العيشه يحب الالوان ما نتصورش الشعب هذا ولا البلاد هذه باش تغلبها اي تطرف مهما كان المأتم نتاعو دونك تونس ما فيها حتى شيء تونس مزيانه تونس بجبلها ببحرها بشعبها بتاريخها بحضارتها وبمستقبلها بثقافتها تونس مزيانه وتونس هي من احلى البلايص من اعلى البلايص في افريقيا في المتوسط دونك فوالا اجيو لتونس